also known as Pallas Athena, is one of the most important goddesses in Greek mythology. She is the goddess of wisdom, courage, inspiration, civilization, law and justice, strategic warfare, mathematics, strength, strategy, the arts, crafts, and skill. Interestingly, Athena is one of the virgin goddesses, also known as the virgin goddess of wisdom, meaning she never married or had lovers, unlike many other gods and goddesses in Greek mythology. Athena is often depicted with an owl, which became associated with her and symbolized her association with wisdom and knowledge. She was one of the 12 Olympians, the principal gods who resided on Mount Olympus. Besides Greek mythology, Athena also played a vital role in Roman mythology, where she was known as Minerva. Athena's birth. Athena's birth is a unique tale among the pantheon of Greek gods and goddesses. According to the myth, Athena was born fully grown and fully armored from the forehead of her father, Zeus, the king of the gods. The story goes that Zeus had been warned that the child of his first wife, Metis, would be more powerful than him. Fearful of being overthrown, Zeus tricked Metis into transforming into a fly and then swallowed her. However, Metis was already pregnant with Athena. Inside Zeus, Metis began to fashion a helmet and robe for her unborn daughter. The hammering caused Zeus to suffer terrible headaches. In desperation, he ordered Hephaestus, the god of blacksmiths, to split his forehead open with an axe. From the opening sprang Athena, fully grown and dressed for war. Even though Metis was consumed by Zeus, she was said to continue to reside inside of him and was the source of his wisdom. In some stories, she is described as Zeus's counselor. Athena's unique birth story underlines her status as a warrior goddess, a symbol of wisdom, and a strategic thinker, which she retained throughout the various myths and legends in which she features. The contest with Poseidon. The contest between Athena and Poseidon for the patronage of the city of Athens is a significant myth in Greek mythology. The city, which was not yet named, was considered a desirable location, and both Athena, the goddess of wisdom and warfare, and Poseidon, the god of the sea, wanted to be its patron deity. The contest took the form of a gift offering to the people of the city. Each deity presented a gift, and the king, Cecrops, who was half man, half serpent, would judge whose gift was the most useful. Poseidon struck the ground with his trident, causing a spring to well up. This was a significant gift, but the water of the spring was salty, like the sea Poseidon ruled, and not very useful for drinking or irrigation. Athena, on the other hand, planted an olive tree. This was a much more practical gift. Olive trees provide food, oil for cooking and lighting, and wood for various purposes. Moreover, olive branches are symbols of peace, indicating Athena's preference for wisdom and peace over warfare. Seeing the greater utility and symbolism in Athena's gift, King Cecrops declared Athena the winner. In her honor, the city was named Athens, and Athena became its patron goddess. The olive tree she planted was said to be seen in the ancient olive tree located on the Acropolis, the fortified hill in Athens where a temple, the Parthenon, was later built for Athena. The myth of Medusa and Athena. Medusa, one of the three Gorgon sisters, is described as a monstrous creature with snake hair and a terrifying appearance. Different versions of the myth provide varying details about Medusa's origin and her encounter with Athena. According to the original ancient Greek myths, Medusa was the only mortal sister among the Gorgons. She and her sisters, Stheno and Uriel, were born with monstrous features, including snake hair, frightening faces, wings, and reptilian bodies. Medusa was a priestess of Athena throughout her life, residing in a town on the coast of Aeolus, opposite the island of Lesbos. However, a Roman poet named Ovid offers a different version of the myth. He suggests that Medusa was once a beautiful priestess of Athena who broke her vow of celibacy and had an affair with the sea god Poseidon. Athena, who was a virgin goddess and had a strong sense of justice and propriety, was enraged by this violation of her sacred space. However, instead of punishing Poseidon, she turned her wrath onto Medusa. She transformed Medusa's beautiful hair into a mass of writhing snakes and made her face so terrifying that any who gazed upon her would turn to stone. In this form, Medusa became a Gorgon, a monster of the underworld. She was eventually slain by the hero Perseus, who used a mirrored shield given to him by Athena to avoid looking directly at Medusa and being turned to stone. Perseus later used Medusa's head, which retained its petrifying power even after her death, as a weapon in several of his subsequent adventures, and eventually gives it to Athena. This myth has been interpreted in various ways, often symbolizing the punishment of hubris, excessive pride, or the consequences of violating sacred boundaries. It also reinforces Athena's role as a protector of civilized life, upholder of sanctity, and dispenser of divine justice. Athena and Arachne. The myth of Athena and Arachne is a story about the dangers of pride and the respect due to the gods. Arachne was a young woman from Lydia, in Asia Minor, renowned for her incredible talent in weaving. She had such skill that the nymphs would leave their groves and fountains to come and watch her weave. Despite acknowledging that her skill came from Athena, the goddess of crafts, Arachne became arrogant and challenged the goddess herself to a weaving contest, claiming she could weave better. Athena was angered by her arrogance, but gave her a chance to redeem herself. She disguised herself as an old woman and warned Arachne not to be so disrespectful and to ask for forgiveness. Arachne scoffed and insisted on a contest. Seeing her unrepentant attitude, Athena revealed her true form. The contest began. Athena wove a scene showing the gods in their glory and power, emphasizing their might and the dire consequences faced by mortals who defy them. Arachne, undeterred, wove a tapestry showcasing the gods' mistakes and misdeeds, including Zeus's numerous affairs. It was a magnificent piece of work, but a direct insult to the gods. Athena acknowledged Arachne's skill, but was enraged by her audacity and the disrespect shown in her tapestry. In some versions of the myth, Athena destroyed Arachne's tapestry and loom. The goddess then touched Arachne's forehead, making her feel guilt and shame for her audacity. Unable to bear this, Arachne hanged herself. Taking pity on Arachne, Athena brought her back to life, but transformed her into a spider, dooming her and her descendants to spend their lives weaving. Thus, the myth explains why spiders are such skilled weavers and why they are called arachnids, after Arachne. This myth serves as a reminder of the respect due to the gods and the dangers of excessive pride or hubris. It also explains the origin of spiders and their incredible weaving abilities. The Judgment of Paris. The Judgment of Paris is an important myth in Greek mythology because it ultimately led to the Trojan War. The story begins at the wedding of Peleus and Thetis, where all the gods were invited except for Eris, the goddess of discord. In retaliation, Eris threw a golden apple into the festivities, inscribed with the phrase, "To the fairest." Hera, Athena, and Aphrodite all claimed the apple. As a way of settling the dispute, Zeus appointed the mortal prince Paris of Troy to judge who was the fairest of the three goddesses. To influence his decision, each goddess promised him a gift. Hera promised him power, Athena promised him wisdom and success in war, and Aphrodite promised him the most beautiful woman in the world, Helen of Sparta. Despite the valuable gifts offered by Hera and Athena, Paris was swayed by Aphrodite's promise. He awarded the golden apple to Aphrodite, thereby proclaiming her the fairest of the goddesses. In return, Aphrodite made Helen, who was already married to King Menelaus of Sparta, fall in love with Paris. This led to Helen's abduction, sparking the Trojan War. Athena, angered by Paris's choice, sided with the Greeks in the ensuing war and played a crucial role in the fall of Troy. This story thus not only illustrates the dangerous mix of vanity and competition among the gods, but also sets the stage for one of the most famous wars in Greek mythology. Athena and Odysseus. In Homer's epic, the Odyssey, Athena, the goddess of wisdom and warfare, plays a crucial role as the protector and guide for the hero, Odysseus. Her support for Odysseus stems from his intelligence and cunning, qualities she highly values. Athena often helps Odysseus indirectly, showing her influence in subtle ways. For example, she pleads with Zeus to allow Odysseus to return home from Calypso's island, where he's been held captive. Later, she aids him in the form of various disguises, guiding him through difficult situations. Here are a few instances. After convincing Zeus, Athena visits Telemachus, Odysseus's son, in the form of Mentes, an old friend of Odysseus. She encourages him to seek information about his father's fate and suggests that he should stand up against the suitors besieging his home, trying to force his mother Penelope to choose a new husband. Athena disguises Odysseus as a beggar to help him gather information about the suitors and maintain the element of surprise for his eventual revenge. She also transforms him back to his noble self at strategic moments. Athena provides guidance and assistance to Odysseus throughout his trials, helping him face the suitors and reclaim his home and family. After Odysseus kills the suitors, Athena, disguised as Mentor, another old friend of Odysseus, helps to instill peace between Odysseus and the families of the slain suitors, ending the cycle of vengeance and securing Odysseus's reign. In all these actions, Athena showcases not only her power, but also the value she places on wisdom, cleverness, and strategic thinking, which are all embodied by Odysseus. This close relationship between the goddess and the mortal hero is a central element of the Odyssey. Athena and Heracles. Athena, the goddess of wisdom, courage, and warfare, plays an important supporting role in the myths of many Greek heroes, including Heracles, known as Hercules in Roman mythology. In the mythic cycle of the 12 labors of Heracles, Athena often assists the hero, providing guidance and aid in his quests. Here are a few instances where Athena's involvement is significant. Nemean Lion. In his first labor, Heracles was required to slay the Nemean Lion, a beast with an impenetrable hide. Athena guided Heracles to the realization that he must use the lion's own claws, the only thing sharp enough, to skin the creature after he had strangled it to death. Augean Stables. During the task of cleaning the Augean stables, which hadn't been cleaned in 30 years, Athena provides Heracles with the wisdom and guidance to route two rivers to wash out the filth, completing the nearly impossible task within a day. Apples of the Hesperides. In one of his final labors, Heracles was tasked with retrieving the golden apples from the Garden of the Hesperides. Athena helped him by guiding him to Atlas, who knew the location of the apples. After Heracles tricked Atlas into retrieving the apples himself, Athena temporarily took the burden of the heavens from Heracles when Atlas tried to trick him into holding it indefinitely. Cerberus. During the final labor of capturing Cerberus, the three-headed dog guarding the entrance to the underworld, Athena guided and protected Heracles, helping him to negotiate with Hades and safely return from the underworld. Even beyond the 12 labors, Athena acted as a mentor and protector to Heracles. When Heracles was driven mad by Hera and killed his wife and children, it was Athena who intervened to save him from his own rage. She often acted as a balancing force for Heracles, providing him with wisdom and guidance to temper his immense strength and fiery temper. Athena also helped Heracles after his death. According to some myths, she convinced Zeus to make Heracles a god upon his death, thus allowing him to join the pantheon on Mount Olympus. Heracles' deification was a unique honor, demonstrating Athena's high regard for his bravery, determination, and strength.